Okay, well, this will be a very quick tutorial on how to make sound play from an object when another character interacts with that object. For this video, I will be using base standard assets inside of Unreal Engine. Now, the only thing that I actually imported would be this audio track I have on Pharrell Williams' song "Happy." Just a random audio track I found on my computer. Didn't feel like looking for anything else, so I just put this in here. Now, first thing to note, if you want to actually get audio and put it into Unreal Engine, you need to have a .wav file, WAV. Now, the reason for that is because a WAV file is the only file that Unreal Engine actually recognizes for this transmitting sound. If you were to import an MP3, you would get something like what I have right here, which says file media source. That basically means that it's a Unreal recognizes it's a file, just doesn't really recognize what file type it is, so it's just gonna stay there in the in our scene. So since this file type is not gonna be used, I'm actually just gonna delete this. So I'm gonna right click and press the delete word, and I don't care about this. Goodbye. Cool. Alright, so to get started, you can always see that I have a object that I made here, and I'll just play this object for you. We'll play the game for you so you can see this in action.
It might seem crazy what I'm about to say.
Now I'm gonna turn that off. Alright. Now, the way I made this is I created what's called a blueprint class. And now, the reason I created a blueprint class instead of just putting a normal cube in here and then putting a box collider in here or a box trigger in here is because the way I always think of objects like a sound trigger is this sound trigger won't only be used in this one specific location, it'll probably be used more than once. And what a blueprint class can do is it can contain all the information for this object into a single file, so that now if I add a new blueprint class and touch that object, the same way that the sound was triggered with this object, it'll be triggered with this object. It's just a way to keep all my game objects and all my code for the game objects contained into a single parameter, a single object. All right. So, I'm going to delete this. Now, I'm going to start out by first, I'm going to right click and I'm going to create a blueprint class. Like so. Now, since this is going to be an actor that we're going to put into the game, I'm going to create an actor class like this. I'm going to name this Sonic Boom. Why? Because why not? Delete this, and I'm going to go into this object by double clicking on it. Now, this is what you will first see when you create a blueprint class, just a little dot right here that doesn't do a single thing. If you want to get rid of this dot, you can always just click on this Sonic Boom self and editor billboard scale, you can just make that 0. The only thing, this object doesn't really do anything in game, it's always hidden in game, but I just leave it there just so I know where the origin is. So I'm just gonna leave it here for now. Now, first, I want to start out by I'm gonna click add component and I'm gonna add a cube, basic cube, like this. I'm gonna scale this cube up the way I want it to, so I'll put it like so. And then I'm going to change the material to a why not? Don't really care. This is what it's gonna be. A brick thing. Cool. All right. Now that that's done, I'm going to add a box collision onto this object. And the reason I'm doing that is because I want it so that when I touch this box collision, it will play audio from a source. This will be the box, the collision that we use to activate the audio. Cool. With that done, I'm going to add in our audio file. Now, the way I normally do this is I go and I go into my content browser, go into, if I have it in a folder, I go into the folder. If I have it just randomly in the content browser, it's randomly in the content browser. But I just go and find my audio file. Click it and just drag it into this scene. Like that. So now I have my cube. Inside this cube I have my box trigger, box collision, and underneath that I have my audio file. Cool. Now that that's done, I'm going to compile this, and I'm going to go into my event graph where I can start the coding for this. Now, to start out, I'm going to delete these two because I don't want them. I might end up using this later on. Not quite sure, so I'm going to leave it there. But first thing I want to do is I want it to be that when I touch this box trigger, it activates something. Now, normally, if you are in a level blueprint, you can just right-click and type in event overlap. And will it actually work here? Yeah, you can do it here. You can go on component, begin overlap. And since you've selected the box, it will select all the options available for that box. So I did on component begin overlap. I'm going to drag in this audio file. And now on the return node for the audio file, I'm going to drag off. And I'm going to just type in play. And you'll see audio, component, audio, and then you can click play. Now, the reason it knows that you're trying to get an audio playing is because you've dragged off on the audio and typed in play. You can always do the play the standard way as well. It's just you might have to look a little bit harder to find some stuff, but here is also still recognized. Alright, so with that done, I'm going to drag off on this execution node, connect it to the play. And I'm going to compile. Now I'm going to turn on the audio speakers and let's test it out. So I'm going to bring this down. I'm going to drag in Sonic Boom. And I'm going to play. It might seem crazy what I'm about to say. So, you'll notice that when I drag this on and I tried to play, the audio automatically plays. Now, that you might think that that's just because I have the audio in this scene normally. So just to prove that that's not the case, I'm going to actually delete this and play the game normally. Now, when I normally play the game, nothing appears. But when I put that object in Sonic Boom, audio plays automatically. That's because even though you have this component set to on begin overlap, it'll automatically play just because Unreal is like, hey, this is audio, I'm gonna play this. So in order to stop that, what you need to do is you need to make it drag off on the event begin play, and I'm just going to drag this again here again. I'm gonna drag off on the music node. I'm gonna type in stop. And I'm going to drag execution node here and compile. Now, when I press play, no audio playing, but when I touch this box, nothing happened as well. That's because I turned off my audio. And also, I probably should check a couple more things. So, let's take a look at what's going on. I don't even begin play. I'm going to stop and make sure no audio playing. Now when I overlap with this box, it's going to trigger the audio to play. So let us take a look here and make sure that everything is working the way we want it to. Let's make this box a little bit wider. And boom. Boom. we go. So what happened before is, one, I forgot to turn the audio back on my computer, and two, mainly, that on the box trigger, the collider was interacting with its box, and we were touching the box on this side, so the box trigger wasn't actually being activated. But when I made this wider, my character was able to touch this box and activate the audio to play. So, compile that again, press play, just to make sure it works again. There. Now, if you want to make it so that when you're not touching this box, the audio stops, it's pretty simple. All you do is, we're going to click on this box, right click, going to go add event for box, collision, and on end overlap. From there, I'm just going to copy the node up there and connect it here, connect this, and we are good to go. Now we try it. Okay, let me stop doing this. I will get distracted by that for a good while. But that is all. That is how you can make audio play from a source and how you can activate it when you interact with a box collider. I hope this tutorial was very helpful for you, and I look forward to seeing you in the next tutorial. Thank you and goodbye.